43:15. I am the Lord, your Holy One. Last week we saw about your Holy One. Hallelujah. This week we are going to see the Creator of Israel. The Creator of Israel. The Lord is our Creator too. Not only Creator of Israel. Hallelujah. He is the Creator of universe. Hallelujah. And He is Creator of Israel. We are spiritual Israel. Amen. Who is Israel? I think in Deuteronomy 33 and the last verse. 29.
Happy are you, O Israel.
Happy are you, O Israel.
Who is like you, O people?
Who is like you, O people?
Saved by the Lord.
Saved by the Lord. Israel means saved people. People who experience the salvation of God. Hallelujah. Saved people, born again people. So, brought out people, separated people. So, we are the people mentioned over here. We can take like that. The Creator. Last week we saw your Holy One. Hallelujah. This week we are saying on the Creator. The Lord. I am the Lord, the Creator of Israel. We can see like that. So we see here how God, in the beginning we know, in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1 onwards we read, please read Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1. In the beginning,
God created the heavens and the earth.
The heavens and the earth. Hallelujah. God created the heavens and the earth. 148 and 5 says, please read Psalm 148 and 5.
Let them praise the name of the Lord.
Let them praise the name of the Lord.
For He commanded.
For He commanded.
And they were created.
Yes. How they were created? He commanded. Hallelujah. By His command, they were created. Amen. The heaven and earth. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. How? He commanded. By His word, He created. But when it came to man, the word of God says, God created man in His own image. 27, verse 27. So God created man
in His own image.
In His own image.
In the image of God.
In the image of God.
He created him.
He created him.
Male and female.
Male and female.
He created them.
He created them. Hallelujah. And what did He do? Verse 7 of chapter 2.
And the Lord God formed man.
And the Lord God created and then formed man.
Of the dust of the ground.
Of the dust of the ground.
And breathed into his nostrils.
And breathed into his nostrils.
The breath of life.
And the breath of life.
And man became a living being.
Yes, and man became a living being. Hallelujah. The Lord formed man and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. So everything, every other creature, the Lord commanded and they were created. And here, man, He breathed His breath into the nostrils of man. Psalm 104, the psalmist says like this, verse 30.
You send forth your spirit.
You send forth your spirit.
They are created.
They are created. You send forth the spirit and they are created. Hallelujah. So how they are created? He commanded. Commanded means His word. His word has a spirit. So how do we speak? How does the sound come out of us? Through the spirit. So God also spoke through His spirit. His word came forth. That's why even Lord Jesus Christ says in John's Gospel chapter 16, that part of it, He says, My words are life, has what? Life and spirit in it. It was created by the command of God. He sent forth His spirit and He created. But here, when it came to man, He created him in His own image, and then personally He breathed His breath into the nostrils of man. And he became a living being. That's why man is so special. Hallelujah. So we know this, hallelujah, this is the first creation, like we read from the Bible, how serpent came to Eve and spoke to Eve, hallelujah. And then how the whole creation, mankind, was separated from God because of this disobedience, because of the sin, hallelujah. Verse chapter 3, we read from that, we know all that, how, hallelujah, God, when the serpent deceived Eve, when God told them not to eat of the fruit of that tree, but, hallelujah, glory to God, giving heed to the voice of the serpent, oh, they forgot about God's commandment, hallelujah, and then sin entered, then they were separated from God, hallelujah, they became aliens to God, rather they became enemies to God, because the now they understand, previously they were like angels, they were having the same mind, same oneness with God, but now they are being poisoned by the serpent, hallelujah, that the serpent, poison of the serpent only was working in them, so they became enemies to each other, mankind and God, hallelujah. In Ephesians chapter 2, chapter 2 and verse 14 onwards, please read.
For he himself is our peace, who has made both one.
Yeah, he himself our peace, who has made both one.
And has broken down the middle wall of separation. Having abolished in his flesh.
Yeah, and having abolished in his
flesh.
The enmity.
That is.
The law of commandments
contained in ordinance, so as to create in himself.
Yes, please understand. So as to create in himself
one new man
from the two,
thus making peace.
Hallelujah. The first creation got spoiled. Hallelujah. By the serpent, Adam. So now, the second Adam, our Lord Jesus Christ, amen, came and what did he do? Abolished.
Abolished
in his flesh the enmity. He is the creator, we are saying here. First creation was spoiled by the enemy. Now Jesus came into this world as man to, hallelujah, make one new man, create one new man, hallelujah. We know how he sent his spirit and, you know, created everything. Even now in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 45, I think, please read. Yeah, 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 45.
As so it is written, the first man Adam became a living being.
The last Adam
became a life-giving spirit.
Amen. Life-giving spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The first man Adam became living being. The latter Adam, life-giving spirit. That's where Christianity starts. Many people think just coming to church we are Christians. No. Christianity starts from the life-giving spirit. How Adam became a living being when God breathed his breath into the nostrils of man. Hallelujah. The same way, Ephesians chapter 2. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Verse 5. Please read.
Even when we were dead in trespasses, made us alive together in Christ. By grace.
You have been saved. This is salvation. You were dead in trespasses. Jesus, by the faith on our Lord Jesus, made us alive. Those who were dead in our trespasses made us alive in Christ Jesus. And by grace you are saved. When you are saved? When you are made alive. Not a dead person again. completely out of the old creation, out of the old man, old life, fallen man, hallelujah, and coming into a new man altogether, that is salvation. By grace you are saved, hallelujah. So here we know, this is what is salvation. God wants to make everything new. And we know in 2 Corinthians chapter, please read 5 and 17.
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ,
if anyone, the only condition is in Christ. That's the main thing. Anyone, whoever, they have to be in Christ. In Christ, again, I want to emphasize, in Christ. Have anyone's mind is in Christ. Anyone's spirit is in Christ. Anyone's heart is in Christ. Anyone's life is in Christ. Hallelujah. Anyone is in Christ.
He is a new creation.
Then he is a new, he will come, automatically become a new creation. Hallelujah. Yeah.
All things have passed away.
What is the sign of becoming a new creation? All things are passed away. Old life will have to leave, will leave. If you are in, the more you come in to the Lord, in the Lord. Hallelujah. All things have passed away.
Behold, all things have become new.
All things have become new. Hallelujah. You will become, all things have become new. No, I'm a born again person. I'm a saved person. But this one area, that one area, no, all things have become new. Hallelujah. Every area of your life should become new. It should be renewed. Hallelujah. Christianity means renewed. Every Christian will say, every year New Year resolution. Lord, I will renew this. Then by the time the year ends, they will go back to the 12. Then again the New Year resolution. Not that way. The day we are, because I kept saying, the day, from that day onwards, we have to become new. New in our thoughts. We know about it, right? In Romans chapter 12 and verses 1 and 2. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies as a
living sacrifice. Holy, acceptable to God. Which is your reasonable service. And do not be conformed to this world.
Yes, do not be conformed to this world.
But be transformed. By the renewal of your mind. That you may prove what is that. Good and acceptable. And perfect will of God.
What are the people who should have the clarity in mind? How? Having the, our minds renewed. Hallelujah. And today I was thinking, lots of things are going on in my mind. Lord says, my people perish for lack of knowledge or ignorance. Lack of knowledge means it is not, the word of God is not talking about the head knowledge. Hallelujah. Lack of knowledge means personal understanding, personal opening of the understanding. Hallelujah. Understanding should personally, and every individual, every Christian should come to that extent. Personally, their understanding should be open. If you are a saved person, just like that, again, people mechanically go to church, come back from church, and monotonously living a Christian. No. Personally, apply your mind, your heart. The more your mind is renewed, the more you will be able to prove that which is good, perfect, perfect will of God. That means you will know God. You will know God's mind. Hallelujah. Personally, for which our mind should be renewed. Our pattern of our mind thinking should be renewed. Hallelujah. According to God, it has to be renewed. Hallelujah. How can it be renewed? By meditating on the Word of God, by meditating on God Himself. Amen. Applying more of your mind onto the Lord. Hallelujah. Than to unwanted, unprofitable, unfruitful things. Hallelujah. Apply your mind onto the Lord. The more you apply your mind onto the Lord and His Word to know Him, the more your mind and understanding of your mind will be open to God, and it will be close to, not I can't say close to the world, unwanted things of the world. The more you will come to know of the heavenly things, hallelujah. The more you will come to know about God personally, hallelujah. You will no more be like a robo Christian. You will be a meaningful Christian. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So the more you apply your mind on the Lord, meditating on His Word, the more your mind is open to God. Amen. The more you open your mind, apply your mind onto the world and the things of the world, the more the mind is crowded with the things of the world and it's close to the understanding of God. That's why people are so ignorant. Hallelujah. That's why they lack understanding. They may know about Jesus. Head knowledge may be there. This personal knowledge of getting, being, having our understanding opened by the renewal of our mind is very, very essential. You get it? Lack of knowledge. The Holy Spirit was prompting in my mind. This is where people lack ignorance, lack of knowledge. They perish. They become captive. Why? Because they don't apply their mind and their hearts in the Lord. They are so much crowded with so many things of the world or many other things. The enemy tries to fill in their minds, and minds are clogged with so many things that won't profit them. But hallelujah, glory to God, if you only do this, oh, your mind will have the clarity. It will be liberated from the bondage of the enemy. All the mind will be liberated from darkness. We read in Ephesians, hallelujah, glory to God, right, chapter 2. How they became, their understanding became darkened, and because of the hardness of the heart, and because of the, please read that clear, that it's talking about the ignorance mentioned over there. Ephesians 4 and verse 18.
Having their understanding darkened.
Having their understanding darkened.
Being alienated from the life of God.
Yes, if your understanding is darkened, being alienated from the life of God.
Because of the ignorance.
Because of the ignorance.
That is in them.
That is in them.
Because of the blindness of their heart.
Because of the blindness of their heart. Hallelujah. Having their understanding darkened and alienated from God. Why the understanding darkened? Because of the ignorance. Because of the blindness of their heart. Why blindness of not applying our mind? You have to spiritually work hard. Hallelujah. Spiritual exercise should be there to find God, to really understand a personal relationship, personal walk with God. Hallelujah. So, this is where people have trouble. If anyone is in Christ Jesus, he's a new creation. All things have passed away. Behold, all things become new. Your mind should be renewed. Then what should be renewed? Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 22. So, we have to give training to the mind. You have to keep training to your mind. Romans 8 chapter, to be spiritually minded is life and peace, and to be carnally minded is death. Again, like as in the Garden of Eden, when they ate of the fruit of the tree, they became dead. If you walk according to the flesh, you will die. If you are carnally minded, it's death. Hallelujah. Romans 8:6-8. And then again, Philippians 2:5, the Word of God encourages us to put on the mind of Christ. Christian, every Christian ought to understand this truth we are not to think like worldly people, but think like Christ. Hallelujah. Every situation we have to bring Christ to our mind and say, how will Christ react to this situation? Hallelujah. How will He deal with this situation? When you only apply your mind, then you get that understanding. You get that light. Darkness goes away. Hallelujah. Ignorance goes away. Then you become Christ-like. Step by step, you have to train up, nurture your mind in a Christ-like way. Amen. Hallelujah. That's how your mind is renewed. And then Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 22. Please read.
That you put off
concerning your former conduct
the old man
which grows corrupt
according to the deceitful lust and be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
And then now be renewed in your spirit. First mind, then spirit also is connected with the mind. To be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
And that you put on the new man.
You put on the new man.
Which was created according to God.
Hallelujah. I told you the old man got spoiled. God did not want to. He said, okay, let me destroy all. He did that during Noah's time. Right? Saving Noah and his family alone. Now God says, why am I going to destroy these people? Let me create out of this old man, hallelujah, a new man. Hallelujah. That's where we are over here. Amen. Praise be to God by sending His own begotten Son into this world. Be renewed in the spirit of your mind, that you put on the new man which was created according to God, or according to God's likeness, in true righteousness and holiness. Hallelujah. So for that, what should you do? Put off concerning the former conduct. You have to put off the former life, former behavioral patterns, former behavioral style. We have to put off former conduct. Remove it. Old man, I don't want the fallen Adam's nature. Hallelujah. I don't want the fallen Adam anymore in me. I want the new Adam, I'm a new man. I want to put on the new man created according to God's likeness. How He created Adam in His likeness. Even now He is giving us an opportunity to put on the new man created according to God in true righteousness and holiness. Hallelujah. So we have to put on the new man. God created the new man, and through believe, putting our trust, we may ask, how can that be? We read right in verse 22, put off the former conduct, the old man which grows corrupt according to the deceitful lust. Verse 23, be renewed in the spirit. First mind we saw, be renewed in your spirit. Because the spirit of man is the lamp given unto given by God unto man, right? Proverbs 20:28, 20 and 27 in English.
The spirit of man,
yeah,
is the lamp of the Lord.
Yeah, the spirit of man
is the lamp of the Lord.
What the spirit of man that we possess is what? Hallelujah. The spirit of man that we possess is the lamp of the Lord,
searching all the inner depths of His heart.
Searching all the inner depths of His heart. Amen. Please know that God breathed His breath into the nostrils of man. Man became a living being. But man, when he ate that fruit, the Lord says he would die. Yes, he became dead by losing the Spirit of God, life of God in him, departed from him. That's the death God mentioned about. But that spirit, that is, when God created man became living being. God and man was twined together, like mingled. couldn't be separated. When sin entered God's spirit, and it was divided into two, man's spirit and God's spirit. God's spirit left. That's a spiritual death. This man's spirit again is given by God, searching all the inner depths of his heart. So long as the spirit of man is one with God, it will be a healthy spirit. Hallelujah. So this spirit, the enemy haunts, like, you know, this spirit, and he, hallelujah, glory to God, we know that the enemy is always after the spirit of man, to put off the spirit of man, not to understand. That's what Ephesians we saw. We were dead in trespasses and sins, and God quickened us. Hallelujah. Through, by faith we are saved. That's why once the spirit was so dead because of sinful nature, when we came to the saving knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, the spirit was quickened. Hallelujah. So this spirit of man is the lamp of the Lord, searching all the inner depths of his heart. That's why the spirit is so very important. Even Jesus on the cross, hallelujah, he said, Father, into your hands I come in my spirit. Because the enemy is after the spirit. Somehow he will not want to allow, let the spirit to reach out to God. So even the last moment, Jesus was so very careful in committing his spirit to God the Father. Every day we need to commit our spirit to God, because for we wrestle not with flesh and blood, but principalities, powers of the all kinds of spirits are warring against what? Our spirit. So our spirit is a lamp given by God. When it is one with God, it can search the depths of the heart, it can understand and know God, and clarity will be there. Hallelujah. Confusions will not be there. So this spirit, the enemy spoiled it in the Garden of Eden. And this spirit has to be renewed. Hallelujah. By giving it to God, Lord, I yield my spirit to you. I want you to renew my spirit. David cries out to God in Psalm 51. When he sinned against God, he says, Lord, verse 10, right? Psalm 51, verse 10. Please read.
Create in me a clean heart, O God.
Create in me a clean heart, O God.
And renew a steadfast spirit within me.
And renew. He's crying out for the renewal of his spirit. What kind of spirit he asked for? Steadfast spirit. Create in me. What's the cause for the spirit to be, hallelujah, glory to God, affected? Not in possessing a clean heart. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. In Proverbs 4, we read, he says, guard your heart with all diligence. Amen. Out of it will flow issues of life. Issues of life. But Jesus also says in Mark's Gospel, chapter 7 and verse 21, he says, what that which goes inside your mouth will not defile you, but that which proceeds out of the heart will defile you. And he lists over there some lists of some 13 types of sins mentioned in Mark 7 and 21. Hallelujah. So this heart, if it is not guarded properly, it will defile the spirit. Hallelujah. That's why we, God's people, should be watchful. Even 2 Corinthians chapter 7 and verses 1 and 2. Apostle Paul speaks about that. Please read. 2 Corinthians chapter 7 and verses 1 and 2. Please read.
Therefore, having these promises,
Beloved,
let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness.
Yes, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness
of the flesh.
Of the flesh
and spirit.
And spirit. Yes, both are important. Let us cleanse from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit.
Perfecting holiness.
Perfection of holiness comes there, not only in the flesh, but in the spirit. Perfecting holiness.
In the fear of God.
In the fear of God. Hallelujah. So let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit. That is holiness. That's how we renew the spirit. Psalmist says over here, create in me a clean heart, O God, and what? Renew the right, steadfast spirit. Not wavering spirit, unstable spirit. For often falling and getting up. No. Give me a steadfast spirit, O Lord. Not the weak spirit. Hallelujah. Pray to God earnestly to live an upright life before God. Hallelujah. So, steadfast spirit. So, how we have to renew our spirit? If anyone is in Christ Jesus, they are new creation in Him. All things will have to flee and all things have become new. We have to keep becoming new, renew. Till when? The likeness of Christ. Putting on the new man. Created according to God in true righteousness and holiness. We'll go back to 4th chapter of Ephesians 22. Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 24. And that you put on the new man, which was created according to God in true righteousness and holiness. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Glory. The enemy doesn't like all this true righteousness, holiness. He's so irritated. So he will try all his tricks. He's a defeated foe. God has crushed his head on this cross. Amen. Praise be to God. So we have to understand this. So be renewed in your spirit. All things have to become new. Amen. So ask God, Lord, renew the rights. Keep yielding your spirit to God. Hallelujah. And also, he who is enjoined with God is what? One spirit with him. Right? 1 Corinthians 6 chapter. Hallelujah, glory to God.
But he who is joined to the Lord is one spirit with him.
Amen. Verse 17. 1 Corinthians 6, 17. He who is joined to the Lord is what?
One spirit
with him. Hallelujah. So always never get separated from God. Never try to move even a millimeter, we say, right? Away from God in our mind, in our spirit. He who is enjoined with Christ is one spirit with God. So we have to be, hallelujah, glory, that's how we can be the new. We are created in the new man is created in us. That's very, very, very important. That's what many people do, many things in the name of Jesus Christ. But Apostle Paul says in Galatians chapter 6 and verse 17,
For in Christ Jesus,
neither circumcision,
nor uncircumcision,
avails anything,
but a new creation.
Those days, circumcision, uncircumcision, these are the traditions of the Jews, or traditional people. Today we can call it traditional Christians. Even spiritual people, they become traditional. Halfway around, they are not able to become spiritual altogether. So they become traditional by going to church, coming back to church, from church. But all this will not do, or all this will not help you. Apostle Paul says, the main, that is the guts of the matter, they say, no? The main thing, the essence of Christian life is new creation. All that the Lord expects of us to become altogether a new creation. Day by day, we have to be renewed. It doesn't happen in one day, right? And Apostle Paul speaks about that in 2 Corinthians chapter 4. And verse 16.
Therefore, we do not lose heart, even though our outward man is perishing,
yet the inward man
is being renewed day by day.
It's a day by day process. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter. It happened all in one time. Yes, we are saved, we are quickened, and then gradually, day by day, our inward man is being renewed. Amen. Hallelujah. So this renewal of our mind is very, very essential. That's why in Galatians we read what he says, Galatians 6:15. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision nor uncircumcision avails anything, but a new creation. A new creation. So we have to put on the new man. He is our creator, right? Creator of Israel. Of course, how God created Israel out of the whole world, He created them, right? In, I think, Deuteronomy chapter 7. The word of God speaks about it. I'll show you. Verse 6. Deuteronomy 7:6.
For you are the holy people
to the Lord your God.
The Lord your God has chosen you
to be a people for himself,
a special treasure above all the peoples on the face of the earth.
Amen. Above all the people upon the face of the earth. That's how He created Israel. Hallelujah. Now, through Jesus Christ, in Christ Jesus, we are created into new creation, and the ultimate purpose of creating us, the new creation, creating in us, is to become like Christ Jesus. Amen. In the likeness of His Son. Day by day, we are being renewed. And then where do we reach? Where's the Lord's destiny? Where we have to put it? What extent we have to grow? Ephesians 4:10. Please read.
He who descended is also the one who ascended far above all the heavens,
verse 13 and 14 we read.
Till we all come to the unity of the faith.
And of the knowledge of the Son of God.
To a perfect man.
To the measure of the stature. Of the fullness of Christ. What's the growth? Limit? Measuring rod for our spiritual growth, Christian growth? Jesus Christ. Himself. For that only, verse 12.
For the equipping of the saints.
For the work of ministry.
For the edifying of the body of Christ.
For equipping the saints, work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, the church He has appointed.
Some to be apostles.
Some prophets.
Some evangelists.
And some pastors.
And teachers.
Why all these people? Fivefold ministry. There are lots of pastors, teachers, evangelists, prophets, and on. They just put all this title. But do they have the vision of bringing people into the full stature? All they have to invest in the kingdom of God, how they have to work, is till we all come to the unity of faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. With this vision only, every ministry should function. Amen. Whether it is evangelists, whether it is pastors, teachers, prophets, apostles. It's not a great thing to have this title before the name or to have this office, but this office should function properly in bringing forth, oh hallelujah, glory to God, the perfect man to the measure of the stature of fullness of Christ. This vision every individual should have and every servant of God should possess. which we really sad to say we don't see at all. They themselves are so very ignorant about this truth. Hallelujah. If you speak about it, they'll say, oh, which theology college or which PhD you've done? Doctorate. You've done doctorate in theology? They may ask. But this is the basic, ultimate, oh, hallelujah, thing that this is the main thing. Why God created man and how, why God sent His Son Jesus Christ to bring people into the newness, hallelujah, to make him and take them into a new creation, hallelujah, to reach to that level. They start, but they don't think about the end, hallelujah, the growth. They born again experience, everything is fine, beginning is fine, but the end, the growth, the stature, what's the measure? Hallelujah, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Amen. This we should have it in mind. And we know about Romans 8:29. Please read.
For whom he foreknew, he also predestined, to be conformed to the image of his Son.
Amen. To be conformed to the image of his Son.
That he might be the firstborn.
Yes. He who whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son. 2 Corinthians 3, last chapter, last verse.
But we all,
with unveiled face,
beholding as in a mirror, the glory of the Lord, are being transformed.
Yes, our being. We are in the process. Hallelujah. The more we really apply to all this, don't look to others as an example, but look to the Word of God, which will give you the understanding on the mind of God. We are being transformed into the same image.
From glory to glory.
Just as.
By the Spirit of the Lord.
The Spirit of the Lord helps us in this. And then finally, 1 John, 3rd chapter. Hallelujah, glory to God. Verse 2. 1 John 3rd chapter verse 2.
Beloved, now we are children of God. And it has not yet been revealed.
Yes, it has not yet been revealed.
What we shall be. But we know. That when He is revealed.
When Jesus is revealed.
We shall be like Him. For
we shall see him as he is. We shall be like him. Hallelujah. And everyone who has this hope in him purifies himself just as he is pure. Hallelujah. If he only has this hope in us, we'll keep purifying ourselves because as he is pure. Amen. Create a new man in you altogether. In Colossians 3rd chapter also it speaks about the new man. Galatians 3rd chapter also it speaks about the new man. Hallelujah. Through baptism. How we put on. If you want to please read that also and finish so that it will be complete. Galatians 3:7. 27.
For as many of you as were baptized into Christ.
Yeah. Galatians 3:27.
As were baptized into Christ. Have put on Christ.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Then, if you are Christ, then you are Abraham's seed, heirs according to the promise. Hallelujah. You are putting on Christ, the new man. And then, Colossians. We'll turn to Colossians chapter 2. And then praise the Lord, glory to God, 12 also speaks about the baptism.
Buried with him in baptism. In which you also were raised with him.
Through faith.
In the working of God. Who raised him from the dead.
And 3, chapter 3, verse 10.
and have put on the new man,
and have put on the new man,
who is renewed in knowledge,
who is renewed in knowledge,
according to the image of him.
Yes, putting on the new man who is renewed in the knowledge according to the
image of him,
image of him
who created him,
who created him. Hallelujah. Putting on the new man. So nice, right? Colossians 3:10. Have put on the new man who is renewed in the knowledge according to the image of him. The image. Satan blinds us from the minds and hearts of God's people, even the servants of God. Image of him who created him. Have put on the new man who is renewed in the knowledge according to the image. The knowledge of God itself is the image of God. According to the image of him who created him. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So this new creation is very, very essential. We have to keep feeling. He is the potter and we are the clay. Hallelujah. As one servant of God came over here, he said, a potter came with his son, such a handsome, beautiful son and all that, he said. And then there was, you know, clay, the clay was there. And then when the clay saw the son of the potter, he said, what a beautiful, handsome son. Can you make out of us the same likeness of your son? Then the potter said, yes. And then he took some clay, the mold. And then he put the clay in there, sprinkled water, he tried to, make. Then the clay said, cried out, saying, no, it's very painful, please leave me, I can't just, I don't want to become like your son. Then the potter left that. And then next, there was another lump of clay over there. And then that clay said, okay, after all, he's sprinkling water and he's just, doing all the work that he's to, crushing it and breaking it and, even stamping on it. That's fine. I would like to become like the son. What a handsome son. Then the potter took that lump of clay and then he tried to work on it and everything, it yielded. Almost it was finished when the potter came with a knife to, carve the eyes. It said, no chance of bringing the knife near me. Better don't come anywhere closer to me. I don't want you to do that. I can't take it. Then the potter left that. Then again the third lump, it yielded completely to the potter and it became like the son of the potter. Amen. That's all. We don't yield to God to be formed in the likeness of his son, to become altogether a new creation. Amen. It's up to us to become altogether a new person, new creation, putting on the new man in the likeness of Christ, the image of God. Change my heart, O God, make it ever true. Change my heart, O God.